Here comes our Syrian athlete. Come on, everybody, let's cheer them all around the corner. Representing the country of Syria, you can imagine what he's been through to train. So this is it, this is our large group. We got our three Canadians in this group. Come on, let's push them through. Up off your feet, put your hands together and continue. Cheer these athletes through. One lap to go. That's the bell lap. Jerry Abola pushing the pace at the front. No surprise there. Mario capable, of course, of sub 15 minute 5 kilometer off the bike. Last year he was just a touch over 15 minutes, 15 minutes 10 seconds. Richard Murray's also in there. He's another one of the fastest runners in the sport of triathlon right now. So we got Javier Gomez, Jonathan Brownlee, Mario Mola, Alzara from Spain, and Richard Brownlee, Vincent Louis from France. These are the fastest in the sport these days. It looks like, I don't know on this last lap if anybody's going to go. Looks like they're sitting up, taking in some fluids, taking in some energy, getting ready for a run race.
All right, let's help these two guys back out on that course.
One of the things I'm sure you've noticed, Tim, is that, of course, our elite men are racing on the exact same course and the exact same distance as our elite women and our paratriathletes. And that's what I love about the sport of triathlon. It's one of the first Olympic sports to adopt full women's equality in their race competition. From the very beginning, from the first World Championships, 1989, organizers and officials insisted on racing the men and the women on the exact same courses over the exact same distance, and it's the exact same prize money in the end. I know it was a bit of a controversy because at the time it was unheard of in the sport for women to have the same sort of prize money as men, but the ITU officials insisted, and a great story is actually ITU officials, when they were told no out of their own pocket, paid equal prize money to the women. They've started a legacy of equality in Olympic sports, which has now been carried through multiple other genres and other sports. And it's now the standard that's upheld at that level.
Still, I can't get my satisfaction.
Push me, and then just hurt me. Do I get my satisfaction?
All right, let's help this fellow out. That's Polyansky from Russia.
See if our Syrian athletes stayed ahead of that lead group and didn't get laughed out. And then we have our large group of the world's best triathletes. Their new bike is down to the last 1.5 kilometers. They're going to rip down Emily Murphy Hill. Let's see how fast they go. 57, 58, 59, 61, 63. And the speedometer continues to climb as they come ripping down Emily Murphy Hill. Mario Mola at the front. 73, 74, 75 kilometers an hour, 76 kilometers an hour. So there we see them jostling to the front. This is when they want to be at the front. They want to be at back coming in transition because they've got to slow down that much earlier and lose that much more time. So there we have one off the front from Ireland. He's not going to sit in there. White, he's going to get some clean space out of their shoes. Here they come. I got a challenge for us, Edmonton. Let's get up off our bums, on our feet. We're going to cheer these athletes on. 15 minutes of running. We're going to cheer them all the way. Come on, let's show them what we've got in Edmonton, what sort of spirit we've got here in Canada. This is your lead group of the 2017 ITU World Edmonton Triathlon Series race. Ben Canute from USA off the front. This is it. Let's turn the music up. Get off our feet. Let's cheer them through this whole 5-kilometer run. The best in the world here.